Welcome to the USCA AC National Croquet Championships held in April of 2021 at the Sarasota County Croquet Club in Venice, Florida. Your tournament director is Jeff Soo, more than ably assisted by his wife Eileen, and Hans Peterson is the tournament manager. This is game two of a semifinal match between Matthew Essick and Stephen Morgan. Stephen won game one, 26-0. This is the best 2 out of 3. In the first game, Matthew won the toss and opened with a super shot. And Stephen returns the favor with blue here in game two. Matthew is considering shooting at that ball from corner one, a tactic that the American team with Danny Honeycutt's leadership has tried a lot in the McRobb, for instance. Chris Clark doesn't like it, and looks like Matthew doesn't either. I'm not sure why he takes this shot from the end of B-Bog when it's easier to be accurate from the end of A-Bog. Maybe he just goes up there thinking maybe I'll do corner two, changes his mind, and doesn't want to walk back. So Red responds to the super shot with the maximum distance on the east boundary. I think this is a little risky because you might leave a double if you miss. Unless you can do that. Center ball from 19 yards. So the hampered hoop at one prevents the third turn three ball break. Matthew walked a couple hundred yards making the decision to take his shot from A-Bog instead of B-Bog. I couldn't tell whether he was trying to set up a triple or what. In any case, that miss let Steven off the hook, and now he's going to take the short shot of black on red. And rather than just make one hoop and set a leave, giving Matthew a shot, he's going to try to get all the balls in play and get a break going instead.
Black is for two, no? Is it blue or is it black is for two?
It's best out of three right now.
Best of three is the three. Yeah.
Oh, well, this game.
That is why rushes, long, short, and in between, is probably what we should all be practicing more than anything else. Blue is a couple yards east of five and a little bit shorter, probably.
That's Matthew Essick.
Did Yen think about coming to play with those ladies over here? Or she doesn't play some? I think she plays some association or not.
Yeah.
But she's
whatever.
Thank you.
When he picked up blue off the boundary to make hoop three, he probably had this in mind, leaving black there so he could pick it up after six. If he were going to do a diagonal spread, he'd be sending black to two back here, but Matthew favors the new standard or mom standard leave almost exclusively in the games I've watched him play. The issue of parity comes up here now. I'm guessing that Steven would rather play black than blue, because if he plays blue, black will have trouble finishing a triple from hoop four. So if he plays black, sets a leave, then blue can triple to win. Matthew knows that. And Matthew's triple off the new standard leave will be easier if the ball that gets wired at hoop four is left in place. So let's see if Matthew leaves black here, takes blue with him, and wires it at four, thus enticing Steven to lift the black ball. Because blue will be a pioneer at black's hoop. Going to check the wiring position from the end of B-balk.
She said she did.
Blue, of course, needs to be rushable to hoop one. at least partially wired from a bonk. And red and yellow need to be where blue doesn't have a shot on them because of a lack of a backswing. And finally, he doesn't want to give a double from a bonk at these two balls. So, yellow makes nine, does a new standard leave to set up a triple by red. This is a new standard leave rather than a mom standard leave because the ball at hoop two is not right next to the hoop. If you look up Clark Croquet, Chris Clark has an exhaustive discussion of where that ball that Steven just kicked with his foot should be in a mom standard leave. I'm guessing that Steven is taking this shorter shot because he knows that no matter where he misses from, Matthew is going to triple him. This is the set shot in this position. Kick black down toward three and then over toward two is the pioneer after he gets back to the blue ball at four and rushes it to one. You don't have to rush it hard, you just have to rush it straight.
Sixteenths is the medium type. 11-16s. Plus. So
As long as it's rushable, that position is as good as making the peel. He's going
to
come back for that yellow ball now. Yeah, you could just as easily do it after five.
In the jaws, it'll go through grace.
Yes, yes. Right. You can recall it. Maybe out of position.
He going to do a takeoff wisely instead of the big pass roll in an attempt to put yellow by six and get to the Pioneer at five. That's usually a disaster. The Pinel peel may be the most useful one to Jaws because now he can use that ball to get to his two-back Pioneer after he makes one back. This lets him set up the rover peel and get access to the two-back Pioneer at the same time. Thank you. That was a little close. And Matthew wins game 2, 26-3, triple peel. They're now tied at 1 apiece.